All right, coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division collision.
This thing is coast.
He was an All-American wrestler at Michigan State, JUCO national champion at Niagara Community College, but in the UFC, takedowns certainly have been on point, but so has the boxing. Outstanding left hook. You can ask some of his previous victims about that. Knocked out Chuck Liddell at UFC 88. That is arguably his biggest win, and that paved the way for him to win the UFC light heavyweight title when he knocked out Forrest Griffin several months later at UFC 92. Sugar Rashad Evans is back for more tonight.
Rashad Evans is an explosive athlete, and he has built his MMA skills around a solid wrestling base and knockout power. He's got a ton of experience against top-flight competition and always brings an intelligent, disciplined game plan into the cage.
Well, you know, this fighter, as he makes the walk tonight, is going to be looking to lean on the speed and the footwork in this particular matchup. Got to keep the hands high, right? You got to stick and move and get the head off the center line, given the power that's coming back. But I'm just not sure that the opponent can match the quickness. Exceptionally fast on the feet. Very good at using angles to set up his offensive attacks and very sound defensively as well. So has the reach advantage, figures to be able to use it here tonight. This is one slick striker with which to contend.
This guy has excellent footwork. He's very difficult to catch inside the octagon. He closes the distance well, and he's always in a position to attack and defend.
Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight tilt. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, and they both possess a similar height and reach. Now for the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the O2 Arena in London, England.
This man is a wrestler with a professional record of 24 wins, 8 losses, and 1 draw. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, ladies and gentlemen, he is the former UFC light heavyweight champion, Sugar! This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 29 wins, 7 losses. He stands 6'1" inch tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Irvine, California, presenting the former UFC light heavyweight champion, Quinton Rampage Jackson!
Alright, been through the rules in the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Have a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
They touch him up, man. We are underway.
You ready? You ready? Let's go.
Dateline, London, England. Good to have you with us as always as we get underway with live action from the O2 Arena.
Rampage Jackson is known for his huge slams. He's a solid wrestler, a power.
Oh! Does here, he postures up and lands to the head.
Big punch from the bottom. Nice. Nicely done reversal.
And he turns it around into full guard.
And he lands a hammer fist.
The elbow is there. Nice job there by Evans. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Just over 3 minutes to go. Both fighters back to their feet now. Straight right hand, no good. Evans gets caught with that punch.
Oh, what a brawl. These guys are going off.
And he's going to try to take the back.
He's got him hurt here. Oh, he might be out.
Really swung for the fences with that hook, but misses.
And he connects there. Well, he's playing with fire here, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable to that jab.
Oh, that
slam there. That one cannot feel good.
And he's trying to pass.
And he immediately, yeah, got that clinch again.
Hook in the clinch there is good by Evans.
Pummels and secures double underhooks.
Evans' lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
He transitions to side control.
30 seconds to go.
And back up again.
15 seconds remain in the round. Pretty good straight punch for him there, Joe. Oh! Round two winding down. Saved by the bell. That's the end of the round. You heard the horn, and it came just as he was stunned by a huge shot right before the end of the round. So, saved by the bell. Back to the stool, 60 seconds with which to recover. We'll see if his corner can keep his head in the fight.
Here's a powerful punch that devastates. Let's see it one more time.
Jenny Andrade to get us going. All right, round two.
Look for him to go on the attack early in this round to try to pick up where he left off in the last round. His opponent was dazed and in big trouble when that round ended. Clean punch.
Oh, man, with that right leg kick.
Excellent movement on the ground here, always trying to better his position.
Back up.
And he connects there.
Oh, he hurt him. He's definitely blocked.
Punch there by Evans. Just misses with the straight right. How about that chin? Just misses with the jab there. Well, he got cracked to the head there, Joe. He's... Oh!
It was a beautiful job setting up that submission, and once he got it, the fight was over.
Yeah, that is high-level stuff out of him there, Joe, to finish the submission. It's one thing to get the dominant position. It's another thing to close the show, and he certainly did that here tonight. That's a big one.
And here's the end of the fight. And here it is again.
absolutely perfectly executed. And one more time, nice technique here on this submission.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest in 2 minutes, 15 seconds of round number two. For the winner by submission, Quinton
Well, what a submission win for this oncoming force here tonight. I think he's going to be a problem for a lot of fighters in this division. Tonight, though, is all about the celebration after getting the finish that he so sought coming in here tonight. You see how happy his coaches are, his training partners. This is going to be a fun night for this team and one that they have richly deserved.
Soldier, ay, always, yeah, I'm never, it's been 3 days in a row.